It's Carrie. In today's 5-Minute Friday, I wanted to walk you through filling out the PRISMA Flow Diagram. The PRISMA Flow Diagram can be found on the PRISMA Statement website, which I'll link below, under the PRISMA Statement heading, and under the Flow Diagram subheading. Now, there's 4 versions here. There are 2 versions for new systematic reviews, and there are 2 versions for updated systematic reviews, and then it's further divided into searching databases and registers only versus searching databases, registers, and other sources. The one I'm going to show you today is this one, a new systematic review that includes searches of databases, registers, and other sources. So let's take a look at that. This is the Word file for the new systematic review that includes searches of databases, registers, and other sources. And what I'd like to do is walk you through filling it out. And I have made up some theoretical numbers today, so not based on any real numbers from a literature search, but just in theory. So the first part is identification, and then that is split into 2 parts. Identification of studies via databases and registers versus identification of studies via other methods. So here we could say that we have found 4,248 total records from our database search. Now notice the asterisk here, which points you down to the footnote that says, if feasible to do so, report the number of records identified from each database or register searched rather than the total number across all databases and registers. So one way or the other, either in your narrative or here in the flow diagram, you should be including your records from each database. So Medline, Embase, Scopus, so on and so forth. And we will say that we found 36 records in registers. Now this would be things like clinicaltrials.gov or the WHO, ICTRP, or other trial registries as appropriate to your topic. Over here, we have a box for removed before screening. So you will probably be doing some deduplication, or sometimes you are using tools that do deduplication. And sometimes there will be records that are removed for other reasons. So let's say that 396 records were removed by our automation tool. Let's say we uploaded them into Covidence. Covidence identified 396 duplicates. Let's say prior to that we had removed 406 duplicates on our own. And let's just say that 4 were removed for other reasons. Let's say we couldn't identify the record or we couldn't find the proper citation or whatever reason we had to remove those records. Then we move into screening. So the next step is title and abstract screening. And this is where you'll be eliminating the bulk of the records based on the title and abstract. We have now identified 3,478 records that need to be screened. And of that 3,478, we've eliminated 2,800 based on title and abstract screening. Notice the double asterisk here for records excluded, which takes you to the footnote that states if automation tools were used, indicate how many records were excluded by a human and how many were excluded by automation tools. We have 678 reports that now move into the full text screening, where we are going to go looking for the PDFs. In this case, sometimes we cannot locate the record or the PDF, and so we're going to say that 35 records were not retrieved, leaving us with 643 records that are assessed for eligibility. Now, at this point in full text screening, we need to exclude them for reasons. So the reasons would be based on your eligibility criteria, your inclusion and exclusion criteria. So you're going to note those reasons here, but for the purposes of this flow diagram, we will just fill out the numbers. Let's say that 250 were excluded for reason number 1. 360 were excluded for reason number 2, and 3 were excluded for reason number 3. That leaves us with 30 records. Now, how do we fill out this last box? There is some clarification in a publication of the JMLA, the Journal of the Medical Library Association, which I will link in the video description, regarding actual studies versus the studies reports. We've ended up with 30 records that made it through to inclusion. 10 of them were actual studies. 20 of them were reports of included studies. Now, I've completely ignored this side, so let's go through this piece. This is the other searching that you should be doing when you're doing a systematic review. So it's not just trial registries and databases. You should be doing some hand searching as well. Let's say we found 4 potential websites that were of interest to us for this review, 1 organization website, and based on citation searching of our included studies, we found 15 additional records. We then sought these reports for retrieval, and we were able to find 7, or include 7, and we needed to exclude 13, which leaves us with 7 that were assessed for eligibility, and we ended up excluding 2 for reason 1, 2 for reason 2, and 1 for reason 3, which leaves us with additional information to add here. Based on what we found from other sources, we ended up with 2 additional studies to include, so that number now becomes 22. So just to review, the identification piece is detailing the number of records found through databases, registers, the numbers removed through deduplication, and records identified from other sources and other methods. The screening section takes you through title and abstract screening and exclusion, full text screening, minus records that were not able to be retrieved, full text screening, excluded for reasons, replicated over here by reports sought for retrieval, reports not retrieved, reports assessed for eligibility, reports excluded for reasons. And finally, the included box. So studies included in the review, actual studies, and the reports of those included studies. Identification, screening, included, via databases and registers, via other methods. If you're doing a systematic review, you should be keeping a PRISMA flow diagram. Good luck! Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.